Okay, I'm going to be showing you how to do a lower unit service on an outboard motor. Mine is a 200 horsepower Yamaha, but they're all pretty much the same regardless of brand or size. The lower unit service includes changing the lower unit oil, the gear case oil, changing the water impeller, and removing the prop to check for any line or any other things that might have gotten inside the mechanism there. You don't need a lot of tools to do this. You need a socket set. Mine takes a 9/16. It's handy to have some open-ended wrenches because in a couple of spots it's tight to get the socket in there. You're going to need a pair of pliers to pull the cotter pin off of your nut on your outboard. You're going to want a bulky flathead screwdriver with a big bit. This is to take off the oil inlet covers, and they're pretty easy to strip out, so you're going to want a bigger thing so it won't do any damage. To take your, when you take your propeller off and put it back on, you're supposed to torque it down to a specified amount of pounds. And with the Yamaha, it's 40 pounds. I know with Mercury, I think it's 55. Best way of doing that is using a torque wrench. I picked this one up at Harbor Freight for about 20 bucks, and it takes it's a half inch. It takes a 1 1/8 inch socket. The whole thing set me back about 30 bucks. Something that I use regularly when I do the service. You can use the plastic ones they make for removing the propeller nuts on outboards, but they don't give you a torque setting, so worth spending the money on. You're gonna want a water pump kit. You don't necessarily need the whole kit. Really, all you need is the impeller, unless something else is wrong. But I got the whole kit, which I have on standby here. It's got gaskets and everything. If there is a problem, I can just swap stuff out. If not, I'll just save this, and next time I'll just get an impeller. These are seals for the drain plugs on your gear oil. There's a little screw and it has a seal on it. You need to replace it every time or it'll leak. I didn't replace it one time, it leaked everywhere. So I got these on eBay. It was like 10 sets of them for, I don't know, 10 or 12 bucks. So you could just look up what type of motor you have, what it takes. It's pretty universal. You're gonna need gear oil. This is Lucas Marine gear oil. You could use your Yamaha or Mercury brand or West Marine brand or whatever. It doesn't really matter. I got this for free, that's why I'm using it. I like Lucas oil products, so no complaints here. And the way you fill a lower unit is from the bottom up. There's two screws. You take them both out and you plug the hose into the bottom one and pump it to fill it up until it comes out of the top hole. That way, there's a lot of chambers in there that can get air. If you pour them through the top, you might not actually fill it up. So you're going to need a lower unit gear loop pump. And this just screws right under the top of this bottle, and you can pump it up. Each motor takes a different amount of oil due to whatever size it is. You can look it up. I think mine takes 32 ounces. I don't remember the last time I did it. But I have an extra bottle just in case. Other than that, you're going to want some gloves to keep your hands clean. Some shop rags. Something to catch your gear oil in. And I've got a piece of cardboard over there I'm using to put under the whole thing to keep my driveway clean. So let's get started. Okay, so get ready to change the lower unit oil. There's a screw here and one underneath, and you need to loosen those both and take them off. And take the bottom one off first, or the top one off first. I usually do the bottom because it creates a little suction and it keeps from all running all over your hand. And then you take this one out. But when you do it, you want to lower the motor down all the way here before you take it out, and have your oil pan set up over underneath it. So it's as simple as a gate. Screwdriver. Taking that out, and then the top one. I've already got oil all over my hands, so my screwdriver is slippery. It is a bit messy. It'll run out faster once you take the top one out and get some ability to breathe. Yeah. There we go. Now it's really poured out of there. So you just go ahead and let that drain out. Now you can see by the color, but it's a pretty good shape.
and not really have any problems. This screw, if it had any metal in there, you'd see it on there. On this part here, it's got a magnetic thing. I don't know if you can see or not, there's very little metal on there, tiny little bit about. I would say it's probably pretty normal, but not excessive. And that's just from the gears grinding a little when you slam it in a gear or in a reverse. So a pretty minor amount. Anyway, it's draining out. You want to make sure and have your motor trimmed all the way down to get it all out of there. Okay, now we're all drained out. So I put this this pump onto the top of this bottle, and it has this little screw, and this actually screws in where the screw hole went. And then we're gonna pump the new oil in. So. Okay, once all the oil is drained out, I've screwed the pump, and it has a little metal fitting that goes in. It's exactly the same size as the drain plug, and you just screw it right in, and then you're ready to start pumping the new fluid in. You're just gonna keep pumping until this comes out the top hole. Ready to go. And it didn't take a whole lot. Probably the last couple drops in the other bottle would have done it. So now we're full. I'm going to put this plug back in, but first I have to get the new gasket. A professional probably would have had these standing by, but I did not, so that's probably why I don't get that many views on my YouTube channel. Alright, so that gasket goes right over the screw. So the you want to keep track of which screw goes on the top and the bottom. The bottom screw is longer because it has a magnet on it, so it's easy enough to see. So get that started. It's amazing how much easier this is when people aren't watching you do it. Come on. Let me try it this way. Oh, there we go. That's exactly what you want to do. Drop it right into the old gear oil. So at least we're getting some comedy here, if nothing else, right? You can laugh at me while you learn. Anyway, this may never go back in. There we go. Alright, so that's important to get as much oil on everything as possible and to sweat a lot because it's hot. That really makes it easier. So I'm going to call that snug. I didn't even get a type because my screwdriver's too slippery, but we're doing what we can here. Once I clean off my hands and get a different screwdriver, I'll tighten it up completely. Okay, so now I got my next washer here ready to go. And my other screw, which I'm going to take the old washer off of. Put the new one on. Drop it on the ground. Make a complete mess, because that's important. Alright, so now I'm going to unscrew this, which is a lot. Slipped it out of my hand. Get the screwdriver in there and find it back up. Okay, I managed to get that all cleaned up and tightened up without further injury and not too much of a mess. I cleaned everything up. I tightened up both nuts or screws, and we're good to go. So Next thing is taking the prop off. There's a cotter pin here, so I'm using a pair of diagonal cutters to bend it. I'm not cutting with it, I'm just bending it. They seem to work better than anything else. And basically you're just trying to get it down so it can come out. It's going to mean pulling it down. Just take your time with this. There's no real rush, and there's only one right way to do it and a lot of wrong ways to do it. It's going to end up with a broken pin or damage your prop. So, like I said, yeah, like I mentioned earlier, there's a lot of wrong ways of getting this out and only one right way. And what I found was I got a small screwdriver and I kind of wedged it in there and pried it a little bit free. And now I've got these same channel locks here. I'm just gently walking it out. Not biting too hard, but I'm just using leverage to pull it through. It's getting a lot easier now. It's coming ways through here. So if you break it, you can just get another cotter pin. I think this one's good for another time or two anyway. So next up is taking this nut off. And to do that, you need to block the prop, which is going to be feeding a piece of wood in here that's going to be stopping it from going in the direction that you want to go. So that's wrong. So here I'm going to put it right here, block it in there, and I'm going to break it loose. So that one time got it loose, but not enough to finger loosen it. So bring around, now it's loose. Okay, so piece of 2x4 sanded head, I just used my same torque wrench to do that. So I am taking this off. And this nut is designed to let the cotter pin go through. It's called like a castle nut or something like that. I'm not sure. I'm going to take this piece out. You want to make sure everything comes out in the right order. So that washer sits on top of that. I'm going to pull my prop. Should come straight off. Then we have this bearing here. I do have some line around the prop. So it's a good thing I did this. That's some Spectre line that could damage that seal. There wasn't any water in my oil, which tells me that this didn't do any damage, but could have if I left it in there longer. So my gasket's looking good. Everything's turning freely. Everything looks good there. So I'm gonna leave the prop stuff there, and now I'm gonna take the lower unit off. There are 6 bolts that hold the lower unit on here, on the outside. And then there's one more that hides up inside of here. And to get at it, you have to take this the skeg off. So I'm going to use my screwdriver. This little rubber cover here, you can pop it out. Now I've got my socket with an extension on it. This is a half inch nut. So these things tend to, these are sacrificial anodes, so they disintegrate with salt water. But one of the problems I had is that with mine, I was losing them prior to, pretty quickly. I'd pull them on a couple months later, be gone. So what I use now is I use a little bit of Loctite on there when I reattach it. So the nut, you can't see it, but it's hiding up in here. Of course, I have to put my other socket, which I'm pretty sure was going to drop on the ground. Okay, I had to switch my socket to a 9/16, and it rolled, fell on the ground and rolled away. So that's what I was looking for. That's right in there. Now this is with this breaker bar on here. It's easy enough to hit your knuckles. So be careful when you're breaking that loose. lower unit's not going to fall off until you've got the last bolt out, so you don't have to worry about loosening them evenly. This one's coming pretty easy. I'm going to go ahead and stop filming as I unscrew the rest of these, and I'll wait till I get the last one down. Okay, I've taken all my bolts off except for the last one, and I've got that one just about out now. So this isn't likely to fall out, but once you take the last bolt out, you want to hold on to it. You're going to want to have somewhere to put this thing once you take it off. It's pretty heavy. I've got a little workbench that I put it on. If you don't, you can just lay it on the ground on a towel or on your workbench on its side. It's easier to work on upright. So now you're just going to wiggle it loose a little bit. That's got a long shaft, so you want to take that straight out all the way. There we go. That's the whole thing. Be right back. Okay, so I've taken this out and I've moved it to my workbench here. And this is a Black & Decker Workmate 225. I bought it on from Home Depot or Amazon for about 60 bucks, and it holds the lower unit really well because it has an adjustable clamp. Makes it easy to work on. So I'm going to be loosening these housing here, this plastic housing. These are half-inch bolts, similar in size to the ones that we're holding on the skeg. Okay, now before I take this cover off, I'm going to see that this spins in a direction. It only goes in one. If it tries to go in the other, it stops, and that's because the impeller is bent going that direction. So we're going to take this off of here. It's kind of tight. Turn it off. This is the housing that the impeller sits inside of. Pretty tight too. There we go. Now I have my impeller, which I'm going to get a screwdriver to pry up. Okay, yesterday while I was filming, my battery in my GoPro died, so I got a little bit ahead of myself before realizing it happened. It's the next day here, that's why I'm wearing different clothing, because I let my battery charge overnight. I took my impeller off, so I'd taken the housing off. And then the impeller on this motor has these rings that sit on top of it and this cap, which kind of makes it seat in the housing. This is specific to my motor. Yours may or may not have something similar. That's what helps to have a parts manual, so you can look and see exactly what's going on. But once I removed these, I was able to take the impeller off. And impellers have an upside and a downside. You can see here there's a keyway here. That's the side that goes down. The side without the keyway goes up because it won't slide onto the key. And the direction that the impeller blades are bent is going to be the direction of spin. So this turns clockwise. So basically, I have taken some just Lucas Oil Marine Grease here, generic Marine Grease. I'm just using my finger. I'm basically putting a light coating on this metal plate. I'm going to put a light coating on the shaft here so everything slides down easily. This also protects it. This is by no means thorough or specific here. There's no right or wrong way to do this. You're just wiping a little bit of grease on everything to get everything lubed up and ready to receive that. At the same time, I'm going to lube up the inside of the can that the impeller sits in. You're not using a ton of lube, you're just getting a little bit on there, give it a little bit of lubrication so everything's sliding. I've decided to change out my entire assembly rather than just the impeller. So I took off the metal plate and the gasket. I've re-replaced that. This is the old housing.
The new housing comes with all new gaskets you have to install. The gaskets aren't going to push up against the side perfectly, and that's okay because once you install this metal cup, it's going to hold them in place. So once you got some lubrication down, a little bit everywhere, just a little bit. You don't need a ton. Just enough to get it wet. I'm going to slide my impeller down my shaft here and line it up with the T-way. If I can see where that's at. There we go. And once it's heated, it should go all the way down to the bottom. Let's see. I'll drop a pick here. All right, so that's seated all the way down. Stuff I dropped. Like I said, if you think it's easy, try doing it while you're filming. It always makes you look like an idiot and clumsy. Anyway, so with that in place, I can put my ring on here. I have those three rings in the sequence that they had. There's two flat ones and a beveled one. So put those back on here. Plastic piece. And this housing. This housing is actually this aluminum piece of what keeps this all situated on here. So I'm going to use my pliers here to get it on there nice and snug. Hey, sorry about the pause there. I wanted to get that piece back on, and since it's not really all that important a thing, I had to fiddle around with it a bit and actually use my vice grips to seat around it and then tap it down with a hammer to get that tight. It's a little metal thing that goes over this plastic cup to keep tension on there. Anyway, as I was saying, these gaskets, the new gaskets I'm putting into the pieces here where they belong, and as long as you can get them lined up pretty well, once you put the metal cup in there, they're going to stay. So there's a little track that goes in here. There we go. And I'm going to get this cup, and it has a notch here where this little lip sits. So get that in position. Make sure the bottom one's still in place. As I would say, with everything here, there's no rush. So if you're struggling to do something, just take your time. It'll none of us do this often enough to be professional at it. So just think of all the money you're saving while it's happening. So you can see that little lip there, the bottom gasket's in place. And I'm going to drop my cup in. There, now everything's locked in. The gasket's locked in place. The one underneath is locked in place. So we know that the this is going to need to turn clockwise. So what I'm going to do here is I lower this on it. I'm going to turn this clockwise to help get the rag, the propeller seated. I don't knock everything off. Yeah, it's easy to pinch your finger, so be careful. Went a little too far, crooked, so it pops up to here and see it. Well, you know, I had it on there backwards. So the little pegs, they line up with these holes, so it'll keep you from making a mistake I just made. So here we go. My thing is turning clockwise and not turning counterclockwise. That means my
should be in order there. So I have new screws to put in here that came with the kit. But before I put any screws in at all, I'm going to put some Never Seize. This is a Permatex anti-seize, and I put that on the tip of the screws so they don't stick. Okay, this Never Seize comes with a little brush applicator. You don't need a ton of this stuff. Just a little bit around the tip of the screw. And this keeps it from fusing together with the outboard's housing here. And keeps everything from sticking the next time you want to take it off. So like with anything on the boat, you're going to want to, that's got more than one bolt, you're going to want to getting a lot here. You're going to want to tighten all your nuts evenly so you can get them started. But don't start snugging down one side without the other, because if you have something uneven, it'll pinch things or mess them up in other ways. So put a little bit on here like that. A little bit of this. Once they're all snug, I'll just go around and tighten them all up a little bit more. That way they're nice and even seated on the gasket. Knocking everything over. Great, right? It's one thing when you're doing it by yourself, but you do it on video. It really makes it look cool. Okay, so our water pump has changed. It's turning freely in there. Doesn't want to turn the other way. I'm going to re-grease this because I've been grabbing onto it, and I'm going to go back and install it in the boat. Okay, I am back here and I am ready to put this lower unit back in. The trick is to get everything to line up in the right hole here. So, sometimes this isn't going to want to go right back in because the gears may not be meshing properly. This side went right in. So it's important to have one bolt ready. I chose this one. Alright, now it's not going to fall off. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and I'm going to do all the bolts, and I'm going to get them all snugged in there and then tighten them evenly like I did with the four before. And the last one I'll do is up in here. So I'll be back once I get those installed. Okay, I've got this all tightened up here, and now I'm going to reinstall my my zinc fin here. I put a little bit of thread lock on that bolt in there already. I use the blue thread lock, which is the removable. I'm gonna start out by getting it going here. You want to make sure it's in whatever position your boat was. When, before you, some of these are cocked to the side. Mine was pretty always pretty straight. You might want to mark a line going from the fin itself to the flange so that you can line it up in the same position again. Line's good there. And I've read that, because I've been having problems losing these, I've read that tapping it and then screwing it can make sure you have it seated properly. I got it pretty tight there, so hopefully that's good. Okay, now it's time to reinstall the prop, but I got to grab some grease first. So I'm just going to use the same grease, this marine grease I was using before. I should have gloves on, but I do not. And I'm basically going to just grease up the whole prop shaft here. Just want to make sure there's a good coat of grease everywhere. And I'll keep... Okay, so my battery died again. I apologize for that, but I've applied the grease to my shaft here. I'm going to install my bearing the way it came out. Sits right in there. I'm going to slide the prop over. There you go. I have the bearing here that sits into the middle there. I'm going to raise this up a little bit so you can see what's going on here. Hopefully that's a good angle. Now my nut and my cotter pin. I went ahead and got a new cotter pin, so I'm going to grab that. Yeah, they had these at West Marine for $5 for three of them. So I got some new ones while I was there. My disorganization has reached epic proportions today. Anyway, so I'm gonna put the nut back on here. And as we saw earlier, we want to have 40 pounds of torque on this nut. So I have my torque wrench set at 40 pounds. Let me verify that. Yep. And I've got my way forward. I've got my block of wood here to block the blade. So, there we go. It only needs to click once. You heard that click? That means it's tight. So, now one of the things you run into here is that the nut is not lining up with the threads, so, or the spot where the cotter pin goes through, so it's okay to go ahead and tighten it just a little bit more until you can let it's almost there. A little tiny bit more. There we go. So now it's lined up. I can stick my cotter pin through. Hopefully the new one I bought is the right size. Seems to go in there okay. Yeah, perfect. So, of course, now I need pliers to do that. I'll be right back. Okay, so this is me doing my complete fiasco. It's a little bit bigger than I need, so I'm going to cut it. Or maybe not. Maybe I'll just bend it. And there's the long end and the short end. It's easier to put it with the long end up, so you can grab that to bend it back. That's what I'm gonna do here. Grab that. Basically, bend it back over the nut. I can bend this one down the other way, keep it out of the way. There, now that's not gonna go anywhere. And that's gonna keep that nut under tight. Not the most beautiful thing, but it's gonna work just fine. So there we go. We got the prop back on. Lower unit is serviced. And that is about it. It's been quite the fiasco the last couple days here with this thing, but hey, It gets a lot easier when you're once you do it a couple of times. I have done it a couple of times, and it usually goes easier when I'm not on video. So there you go.